I was broken with blinded eyes. I was caught up in the chains of darkness. Fragile heart, meant to die. Till love found me and saved my life. Never lost, cause in you I take refuge. Wherever I go, your love surrounds. In you I'm found. I sing your praises, I scream
pastors here, and Pastor Jaylord asked me to preach today because he is having a wedding. Okay, he's having a wedding at La Union. So I'm one of the pastors, by the way. Sa mga nasa online po natin, welcome. Okay, we are Victory Year One Church. Okay, in multiple location, and we are also One Victory Quezon Avenue in different worship services. Okay, kung meron po tayong Saturday, meron din po tayong Sunday. Okay, I'm particularly assigned in 5 and 7 p.m. So, meron po kayong kakilala na hindi po nakakapunta ng Sabado, na available po ng alas 5 ng Sabat ng Linggo, i-connect niyo po sa akin and we will be walking with God together. And as we start with our series this morning, okay, we will be starting a brand new series called Beyond Kings and Kingdoms, because we believe that this coming election, it's timely for us to hear what does the Bible says about Christians making a stand in this particular season. Okay? Madami po kasi sa ating confused, no? Paano ba ako mag-e-engage? Paano ba ako, how will I make a difference in the midst of this seemingly chaotic situation, di ba? Yung ang daming mga bashers, ang daming kulay, no? Kaya yung iba sa atin, brown na lang, o kaya black na lang yung kulay nila, no? So anyway, the title of our message this morning is When Situation is Beyond Your Control. Have you ever experienced being caught up in the middle? Yung parang naipit ka sa gitna, right? Meron kang kaibigan na kulay, magsasabi na ako ng kulay ha, kasi magkaiba talaga sila ng kulay, no? Merong isang periwinkle, or di ba, pink, or meron din naman, ano ba, crimson, okay? Para hindi sila hahalata, no? Crimson tsaka periwinkle, di ba? Tapos ikaw, dito neutral ka, okay? Ano ka, seaweed color ka, okay? Hindi ko na alam kung anong kulay yung... So, they were fighting, tapos nagrarant sila. Say, have you ever encountered that, caught up with that situation? Nasa gitna ka? O kaya yung boss mo, or yung supervisor mo, nagsabi sa'yo, may problema. Tapos yung problema, yung nililid mo. Hindi mo alam kung paano ka mag-handle. And we are in the season of cancel culture, right? Ang daming mga tao na gustong patunayan nila na sila yung tama. Amen? Ang dami pong mga magkaibigan na nag-unfriend. On a serious note, there are serious implications of people who are being caught up in the middle. Okay, I've known someone who paid a certain number of years because someone failed to include the income tax return sa sahod niya. And then this person suffered because someone made a mistake. Are we here? And there are a lot of more serious implications when people are being caught up in the middle. Ito yung mga nawalan ng trabaho, di ba? Kasi merong mga leaders na mali yung decision. May mga tao naman na nagkaroon ng financial difficulty, kailangan nilang umalis ng bansa kasi nagkaroon ng economic collapse. Maybe you felt that. You're a businessman, okay, or you're working in a big company. There's a gas hike. So, ang dami po natin. I'm sure all of us, we are caught up in the middle. Especially ngayon, climate change. Diba? Nakakita niyo po ba yung Google? Nag-search po ba kayo sa Google lately? Hindi. Mag-search po kayo ngayon. Pero wag na yung service, ha? Mamaya. Okay? Okay. Nandun po, pinakita from 2000 and then 2020, yung itsura ng Iceland, ganito, tas ganito na ngayon. Tapos, so, they're saying that 2030 will be the end of it all. Okay? Scientists are rallying because of this climate change. I'm sure some of us or were aware of that. Kung hindi ka aware, pansinin mo ngayon lang bumagyo sa April. Right? Summer. And we are becoming more uncertain with this situation. And this message is for everyone who are being uncertain for the future. Who are being caught up in the middle. So I want to invite everyone to please stand as we read God's Word together. Okay, so open niyo po yung app niyo and look for Daniel, the book of Daniel. Okay, for the sake of time, we will be reading 7 to 8 verses. I encourage everyone to read chapter 1 so that you can learn more about this chapter. Kulang po yung oras natin to preach, no? Para po i-cover up natin yung mga pwede natin matutunan dito sa chapter na to. But it says in verse 1, basahin po natin. In the third year of the reign of Jehoiakim, king of Judah, Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, came to Jerusalem and besieged it. We're here during the time of Tayo. Sino po naka-attend ng series ng Tayo or Tayo? Right? Magkadugtong po sila. Okay? Yung tayo, or tayo, it's the time after this situation, after this Daniel chapter 1. Okay? Bumalik na po sila sa exile. And then, in this chapter, they were about to go to, they went to exile actually. Yan, ginera na po ni King Nebuchadnezzar yung Jerusalem. In verse 2, and the Lord gave Jehoiakim, king of Judah, into his hand with some of the vessels of the house of God, and he brought them to the land of Shinar, to the house of his God, and placed the vessels in the treasury of his God. Verse 3, then the king commanded Ashpenaz, his chief eunuch, to bring some of the people of Israel, both of the royal family and of the nobility, youths without blemish, of good appearance, and skillful in all wisdom, endowed with knowledge, understanding, learning, and competent to stand in the king's palace and to teach them the literature and language of the Chaldeans. Tignan mo naman yung katabi mo, mukha bang without blemish, mukha bang skillful, or, pastor, mukhang ano to ah, high profile, pastor. Okay, mukhang pang king's palace, ganun ba itsura niya? Okay, so pwedeng ma-exile yan. Pwedeng dalhin sa exile. Okay, verse 5, the king assigned them a daily portion of the food that the king ate and of the wine that he drank. They were to be educated for 3 years, and at the end of that time, they were to stand before the king. Among them were Daniel, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah of the tribe of Judah. And the chief of the eunuch gave them the names Daniel, called Belteshazzar. Maganda pong pangalan sa baby yan. Hananiah, he called Shadrach, another one. Mishael, he called Meshach, and Azariah, he called Abednego. Let's bow our heads and pray. Lord, we commit to you, Lord God, this time to hear and reflect, Lord God, what you want us to do in this particular time of the year, that we will be facing transition in leadership, Panginoon. Salamat po, God, that every Christian, meron po kaming participation at meron po kaming role to play, Panginoon, in this time of the year. Salamat po, Lord, that we will fulfill your very purposes, Lord God, in and out of season, Lord. May you pierce every heart, Lord God, that we will be transformed through your word, through your gospel, in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. You may now take your seat. Sa mga nasa online po, you may now also continue watching. Okay? The context of Daniel, they were caught up in exile. Okay? Nagkaroon po sila ng, God allowed them to be exiled, magirahin ng kalaban nila, no? In this particular topic, King of Babylon. Okay? Bakit sila, ba't pinayagan ni Lord? Di ba ang intention ni Lord, gumawa ng nation that will be set apart for Him. Di ba? That's the purpose of Israel. That will be different from all the kings, from all the kingdoms of that known world. But why did God allow the Israelites to go through exile? Because the kings who led Israel became evil. They were evil. Ang sama po ng ugali nila, no? They're worshiping different gods. To worse, they're offering their children. Sinasacrifice po nila yung mga anak nila for their so-called gods, small g gods. And God detests them. It's punishable. That's why God should have annihilate all of them. Kasi parang wala eh, wala nang silbi. Kaya nga ako nagtayo ng nation eh. Para sa akin, tapos hindi naman ako susundin. If I'm God, gagawa na lang ako ng bago, 'di ba? I-snap ko na lang sila, tas tapos na. But God in all his grace, later on we will see that the Israelites endured up until now. Nakita po natin, meron pa ring Israel, right? Some of you were wanting to go to Israel to have a tour, okay? Yung Bible tour. Meron tayong ganun sa Israel, no? And God punished Israel. It's in 2 Chronicles. Take note nyo na lang po yan, no? Chapter 36, verse 17 to 21. Doon po yung time na pinanish siya. Across the board po lahat. Okay? Young men, young women, virgin, old, and middle age. Wala pong pinalusot. Okay? Walang hindi namatay. Except for those who went to exile. Balik po tayo sa chapter, sa verse 1. In the third year of the reign of Jehoiakim, king of Judah, Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, came to Jerusalem and besieged it. Looks like, ang haba pong Nebuchadnezzar, Nebu na lang ha, tawag po natin sa kanya, si Nebu, parang Nebu. Looks like Nebu is ruling and reigning over Israel. Okay? In the eyes of men, pag nakita mong ginera ng Russia, ng US, or ng US, ng Russia yung Ukraine, parang ano eh, di ba? Wala si Lord. Right? It looks like God is not in control. When we are being ruled and overcome by certain problems and issues of life, you're facing, I don't know, maybe you have someone you love who are sick and you feel like God is not in control. You feel like when you're praying, it's not based on the scripture that's happening. Yung promise ni Lord sa'yo, He will prosper you, pero baliktad, no? You're in debt. Is God still in control in the midst of chaos? Okay? We will see that in verse 2. May election ngayon, merong magbaba, merong feeling natin, corrupt pa rin yung bayan natin. Kahit sinong ilagay mo, ganun ka na mag-isip, no? Wala nang pag-asa yung Pilipinas, aalis na lang ako dito. Kasi wala na, parang feeling ko si Lord, inabandon na yung Pilipinas. Maybe you're thinking this way, is God really not in control? Especially ngayon, COVID, may gera. Di ba, hindi pa tapos yung COVID, may gera, tas merong gas hike, tapos may eleksyon. Parang sama ng eleksyon eh, no? You know what I'm saying, di ba? Praise God, alam niyo po, nag-i-improve tayo, hindi na nga nagba-brown out eh. Remember, pag mag-i-election dati, di ba, pag nagba-brown, uy, practice. Practice na to ah. Ngayon, walang brown out. Why? Because we're improving. Amen? In verse 2, kung talaga bang hin-control si Lord, ito po verse 2, no? And the Lord gave Jehoiakim. It seemed like King Nebu is the one who's leading and besieging Israel, okay, and taking them into exile. But in verse 2, it clearly says that God is the one who allowed these things to happen. The Lord gave Jehoiakim. Why? Because Israel sinned against God and He used other kingdom for them to be punished. Para Maria, ang purpose po ni Lord, hindi lang para parusahan yung Israel. It's for them to come to a point that they will go back to God. So if you are in a place where you feel like God has abandoned you, probably that is a prompting from the Lord. Now, anak, balik ka na. Namimiss na kita eh. Remember the very first time na na-encounter mo si Lord. Di ba parang walang tutugtog pa yung mga love song, di ba? If we can build this thing, di ba parang, nothing's gonna stop us, di ba parang, lahat ng naririnig mong love song, parang sa inyo lang ni Lord. Pero nagka-problema ka na, Lord, nandiyan ka ba? Si Lord ba pang good times lang? O pang bad times din? In this verse, we can say that in all season, God is present. God is present. So kung nasa rock bottom ka ngayon, feeling mo wala ka nang pupuntahan. Sabi nga nung sa palabas ng song, di ba? There's no way, when you're at the rock bottom, there's no way but to go left. Up, di ba? Sa taas lang, wala ka ibang pupuntahan. Even things are not going well, God is still in control. Unpleasant situation is not a reason for us to be unfaithful to God. If you're planning to turn your back against God, hindi po dahilan to para sabihin mo, Lord, pinabayaan mo na ako eh. Lord, iniwan mo na ako sa ere. Okay? Pag di nanalo yung kandidato ko, Lord, wala na, alis na ako, punta na akong Mars. Eh, paano nga pag nangyari yun? Feeling mo, ito na yung God-anointed person, di ba? Lord, talaga ito yun, answered prayer, lahat nandito, no? Malinis, di ba? Nag-serve. Okay, kung ano yung sinabi Lord sa scripture, leader, shepherd. Lord, nasa kanya ng lehet. Nasa kanya na, Lord. Tas di nanalo. So, ibig sabihin ba nun, hindi God, hindi si Lord in control? Lord, can I educate you? Parang mali eh. Are we here? Kung hindi yun yung will ni Lord, hindi ibig sabihin wala siyang control sa nangyayari sa atin. Even if your candidate will not win as a Christian, we will still fulfill the very words of God. Amen. We will still pray for them. We will remain faithful. Okay? Hindi nyo binoto si President Duterte noong 2016? Our pastors, some of them, they did not vote for President Duterte. And when he won the presidency, we prayed for him. Kaya kung sino po yung iluklok dyan, we will continue to pray. Regardless kung feeling mo, corrupt niya. Because God called us not to put our trust in the government alone. We will trust them that they will do their part, but we will trust God above all. That we will fulfill His very call for us to pray for our leaders. Unpleasant situation. Another one, our faithfulness to Him doesn't depend on our situation. Ito po mga kapatid, na-exile na po si Daniel. According to 2 Chronicles, lahat po ng hindi na-exile, namatay. Daniel doesn't have his family with him. Wala po, ang kaibigan, kasama niya yung tropa niya. Yung kasama niya mag-Mobile Legends. Yun po yung kasama niya. And God placed them into exile. Can you just imagine the pain that Daniel is experiencing? Nawalan siya ng pamilya. Nawalan siya ng relatives. Nawalan siya ng bahay. According to the scripture that we read, di ba, yung royal family and of nobility, nasa comfort zone ka na eh. Tapos dinala sa exile, among whom is Daniel. Isa po siya doon. Okay? Mahirap po yung pinagdaanan niya. And yet, he did not compromise. The Lord gave. Sabi po doon, the Lord gave Jehoiakim to the king of Babylon. God is in control. God is sovereign. Even if you feel like it's in a negative way, He can still lead you. Kung yung plano mo, hindi yun yung nangyayari ngayon, that doesn't mean God doesn't have plan for you. Sa mga planners po natin, minsan po may plan A to Z ka, tinalo mo pa yung conseys, okay? Hindi nangyayari yung plano mo doon, that doesn't mean that God has abandoned you. He has plan for you. Okay, if you will think about it, kapag ka hindi nangyari yung plan, tas parang hindi pleasant sa'yo, sakit, di ba? Painful eh. Pero alam niyo po, meron nung nag-leadership 113 kami, I caught one nugget of truth there. Sabi doon, pain is God's extension of grace. Kapag nasasaktan ka, hindi yun pinapahirapan ka lang ni Lord. It's an extension of grace. Why? Sabi po sa Exodus chapter 32 verse 9 to 10, kapag may ginawa kang mali kay Lord, dapat ang kapalit nun, death. Pwede kayo nang patayin. Pwede kayo nang tanggalin sa mundo. No? And the Lord said to Moses, this is the time when Moses made the Ten Commandments, di ba? Siya yung unang gumawa ng iPad, nasa bundok. Bumaba siya, nakita niya, nag-worship itong mga Israelites ng golden calf. And God said to Moses, verse 9, I have seen these people and behold, it is a stiff-necked people. Now therefore, let me alone that my wrath may burn hot against them and I may consume them in order that I may make a great nation of you. Pwede niya pong patayin na eh, tapos na eh. And Moses plead to God, no Lord, huwag mo silang patayin, huwag mo silang tapusin. Okay? And God, in all His grace and mercy, He extended the lifespan of Israel. He punished them instead of this totally destroying them. If you are being caught up in the middle, you are righteous in your location, sa community mo, ikaw yung Kristiyano sa mundong ginagalawan mo, tapos kasama ka doon sa nagsasuffer ng consequence ng mga taong mga hindi naman sumusunod kay Lord, okay, you feel like it's unfair. You feel like, Lord, hindi ko deserve to eh. I am faithfully giving my tithes, tapos kasama ako doon sa magbabayad na malinong isa. Lord, hindi naman kami, nag-ingat kami, Lord, sa COVID. Tapos ngayon, nagka-COVID yung family ko kasi merong isa sa aming nagpabaya. You have that thought before. Okay, nagpa-booster ka na at lahat, tinamahan ka pa rin, di ba? Parang, what happened to Daniel? How did he respond in spite of all the loss, in spite of exile, in spite of going out of his comfort? How did he responded? How did he live a righteous life in the face of suffering because of the disobedience of Israel? In verse 3, puntahan po natin, then the king commanded Ashpenaz, his chief eunuch, to bring some of the people of Israel, both of the royal family and of the nobility. Verse 4, youths without blemish, of good appearance, and skillful in all wisdom, endowed with knowledge, understanding, learning, and competent, and to stand in the king's palace, and to teach them the literature and language of the Chaldeans. Ganito po yan, mga kapatid, no? Si Daniel, ang nakikita niya lang, na-exile sila. Right? Na-exile kami, nawalan kami ng tao, nawalan, alam mo yan, nawalan ako ng mahal sa buhay. Probably, ganun din po tayo kapag nagka-problema tayo. Di ba, nakatingin ka lang doon sa problema, nandito lang. Lord, wala kaming pambili ng bigas. Lord, wala pa akong love life, God. 16 years old na ako, Lord, wala pa rin akong love life. Parang nakakahiya naman. No? Yeah, ang dami mo pang taon. Okay? Lord, yung client ko hindi nag-respond. Yung tinawagan ko, Lord, hindi. Yun lang yung nakikita natin. But God has other perspective. Kung tayo, maliit lang yung nakikita natin. Yung perspective ni Lord, hindi niya naman nakita na nag-usap si King Nebu eh, na okay, oh, kuha tayo ng ng mga royal family. And wala siya doon sa staff meeting ni King Nebuchadnezzar. Ang alam lang niya na exile sila. Ang alam lang niya dahil yung king namin, evil, and then we went to exile. But God has other perspective. If you will look at the chapter, pag binasa mo doon, God took care of them. In the midst of exile, they were well fed. Sabi doon, for 3 years, they have to be trained and to be equipped to represent the king. Okay? Hindi sila papahirapan. Ite-train sila. God took care of them in provision and sustenance. Because God has bigger plans. Kung feeling natin exile, si Lord, iba yung plano niya. Let's continue. Verse 5. The king assigned them a daily portion of the food that the king ate and of the wine that he drank. They were to be educated for 3 years, and at the end of that time, they were to stand before the king. Okay? To stand before the king, it means that they will be representing the king. Okay? Dahil na-train ka, che-check ka ngayon ni King Nebuchadnezzar, okay, mukhang okay to ah. O sige, pwede ka na. Okay? Kapag wala ako, you will represent me. Okay? On my behalf. Okay? You will be my representation. Bine-brainwash po sila ng Babylonians. They are changing the externals. They change the name, right? Binago eh. Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego. Some of us, mas kilala nga natin sila sa ganung pangalan, right? Hindi natin sila kilala sa Azariah. So binrainwa sila, okay? But, okay, how did he responded? Okay lang, hindi siya kumontra doon. But when his devotion to God, okay, will be affected, that's the time Daniel stood up. When you are caught in the middle, it's okay to, you choose your battles. Huwag po natin lahat papatulan. Okay? Ang filter po natin, kung yung devotion mo kay Lord, apektado na, then you will stand for what's right. In this political situation, kung yung devotion mo kay Lord, naapektuhan na, dun tayo tatayo. Eh, nakakapag-worship service pa rin naman tayo, right? Regardless of whom is sitting in the government, we can still have our worship service. Amen? Siguro, ang titignan natin dito mga kapatid, yung mga kandidato na same-sex marriage, pro sila. Pro sila sa mga bagay na hindi naman according sa scripture. More than just serving, more than just the credential kung korupto, eh ano ba yung view nila about the scripture? About the laws of God? Doon po tayo makikialam. Okay? And Daniel, he stood up for what's right because his devotion were affected to God. Pinakain po sila ng mga forbidden food, according to chapter 1. And here's the response of Daniel. But Daniel resolved that he would not defile himself with the king's food or with the wine that he drank. Therefore, he asked the chief of the eunuchs to allow him not to defile himself. Did you know if you disobey or oppose the commandments of the king, you know what will happen back then? Alam po natin, no? You will be... If you... Sa mga susunod na series po natin, papakita po doon si Daniel pumunta sa lions din. Because they stood up for what's right. Because of their devotion to God. They did not compromise. They were to be trained before the king. The intention of King Nebuchadnezzar is to for them to represent him, to stand in front of the king, but God has other plan. Okay? At the end of the chapter, sabi po dito, basahin ko na lang, no? Dahil po hindi po nag-compromise si Daniel, sabi po dito sa verse 18, at the end of the time, wala sa slide po yan, no? When the king commanded that they should be brought in, the chief of the eunuchs brought them in before Nebuchadnezzar. Okay? And in verse 20, in every matter of wisdom and understanding about which the king inquired of them, he found them 10 times better than all the magicians and enchanters that were all in all his kingdom. So, ibig sabihin, his intention, human intention, represent him. Okay? To be trained, to be brainwashed. But God's plan is different. They were to represent God in front of the king. Are we here? As we end, he who faithfully kneel before the Lord can stand before the kings of this world. I'm declaring some of us, you will have that influence that will touch not just the people around you, but even people of influence, not kings, but people who are like kings of this world, people who are leading this nation. I'm claiming that one of the people who are here today, or here even in our church, will have an influence. Mapagpe-pray po natin, mapupuntahan mo yung isa sa mga officials natin. And you will have dinner with them and you can pray for them. Meron po akong na-meet na senatoriable, kaya lang hindi ko na po napag-pray, nagpa-picture na lang ako. Wala po sa slide, kasi po wala nang time eh. Nataon po nakita ko siya sa airport. Paalis na kami eh. So hindi ko na po siya, ano sir, pwede ko po, hindi ko na po na ganun kasi magbabayad po ako ng rebooking kapag... So, but I prayed for the person. As I took picture with him, hindi ko po siya iboboto. Si Senator, de biro lang, wala po. So, bawal po, bawal magsalita. I prayed for him kahit hindi po siya yung boboto ko, na God will reveal himself to him. Okay? Isa po sa mga senator, hulaan nyo na lang po kung sino sa kanila. Lalaki po, okay? Yun na lang, lalaki. Okay? We can stand before the kings. We can be of influence. We can use and channel our negative situation for the glory of God. Amen? As we end, Jesus, in Philippians chapter 2, because he fulfilled and he obeyed God with his very purposes. What happened to Jesus in Philippians chapter 2, I want to call the music team as we end. And being found in human form, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Jesus was caught up in the middle. Kailangan ba niyang mamatay? No. He doesn't have any obligation for us. It's not a requirement for him to become a God that he will die first so he can be God. No. He is already God. He's caught up in the middle. And yet, God obeyed him. He did not compromise. He did not question God. The moment God told him, I can just imagine, Roel, Layug version po to, I'm just imagining. While they were having a staff meeting, oh, sino sa inyo yung bababa? Holy Spirit o Jesus? Oh, si Jesus na lang. Oh, sige, baba ka. Jesus, walang oppose, walang, bakit ako? Pati na si Holy Spirit, di ba? Hindi siya tao, spirit siya. Okay? Hindi siya mahirapan. Ba't ako? But Jesus, sabi po dito, He humbled Himself. He obeyed. He became obedient to the point of death. And therefore, God has highly exalted Him and bestowed on Him the name that is above every name. So that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth. And every tongue that Jesus Christ, confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God our Father. I'm claiming this verse for all of us. That as we humble ourselves before God, as we remain faithful in the midst of chaos, in the midst of crossfire, we are going to remain faithful. God will exalt us. God will exalt your business. God will exalt your family, your career, your love life, your future, our future. And we will never be rattled. Climate change, hindi pa darating, hindi pa end ng mundo. Kasi hindi pa napipreach yung gospel. Yun yung sabi sa word eh. The gospel must be preached and then the end will come. I will never be shaken because I believe in this word. Amen? Let's bow our heads and pray. Lord, thank you for letting us experience, Lord, not in the high time, not in the low time, but Lord, in the middle of it all. And yet, Lord, we can still see your glory, your goodness, your faithfulness, Lord God. Lord, it may not be the way we are expecting it, Lord God, to happen in us. But Lord, we know you have other plans. You have better plans for us. That's why, Lord, today, whoever who's watching and listening, Lord, today, who are doubting you and questioning, Lord God, your presence, Lord. Lord, open our eyes. Past, present, and future, high time, low time, in the middle, wherever we are, you are there with us. You will never leave us nor forsake us. Thank you, Jesus, for being the model that we can look up to, Lord God, whenever we are caught up in the middle. That we'll be obedient. And Lord, thank you because of your grace. You're the only one who became obedient even to death, Lord. Lord, you're calling us to deny ourselves, to die on ourselves for the glory of your name. Can you talk to God with your own words? What are some times or moments where you disobeyed God by not humbling yourselves just like Jesus? When you got caught in the middle, you became unfaithful at some point. For men, we're still struggling in purity. There are times you're compromising. You feel like you became unfaithful to God. You confess it before the Lord this morning. Maybe for some of us, you're stabbing or talking people behind their back because you hate them, you envy them. This is the time to repent before God. Or maybe you feel like you're left out. You're being left out because lahat ng mga kasama mo nagsikinasal na or na-promote na. Masenso na sa buhay, ikaw, nandito ka pa rin. You're stuck in the same situation. Kasama mo, hindi mo nakabatch, hindi mo na mas bata na sa'yo. Sa gitna ka lang. And you doubt God of His abilities. Lord, you see our hearts. You know the deepest secrets, Lord God, of our lives. And yet you forgive us. Thank you for your forgiveness. Thank you for your grace. Lord, today, on behalf of your people, Lord, we are in agreement that we will be under your lordship. By your grace, we will obey you, O God. If you're agreeing with me today that you want to be under the lordship of Jesus, you're agreeing with me, could you stand on your feet? Could you stand on your feet? You're agreeing with me right now. Lord, I want to be under your lordship. Thank you, Lord. To those of you who repented of your sins and decided today to follow Jesus, and repented of your sin and asked God for His forgiveness, could you stand on your feet? And we will be partaking of the communion. Because we already repented of our sins, because we asked God for forgiveness, the table for communion is now open. To those of you who are at home, please do prepare a piece of bread and a glass of juice, and we will be partaking and celebrate communion. That on our behalf, Jesus Christ died on the cross. In 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 23, it says here, "For I received from the Lord what I also delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night when he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, 'This body which is for you, do this in remembrance of me.'" You know, brothers and sisters, I thank God my Jesus is strong. Our Jesus did not just die the moment he was pierced, the moment he carried the cross, the moment he got wounded. He died on the cross for hours so that we can receive healing. Lord, thank you today. We can be well. Lord, we can endure. We can live life to the full, O God. Lord, to those of us who are sick today, in the name of Jesus, God, we are claiming healing, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, that we will not stop hoping for healing, Lord God, because you already died on the cross. And life will be better, Lord God, for us. Lord, today we remember your body that was broken. Lord, today we can live in victory. Thanks be to God, our Lord Jesus overcame death. The body of Christ broken for you. Thanks be to God. Let's partake of the bread. In the same way also, he took the cup after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes." Lord, today we want to proclaim that we are already purchased by the blood of Jesus. That we are already bought with a price. That without shedding of blood, there will be no forgiveness of sins. We are already forgiven. And we are without blemish, Lord God. Thank you, Lord, today. There is no guilt, no shame to those who wants to approach your throne. And you are gladly to accept us the moment we repented. Thank you, Jesus, that the moment you were experiencing bloodshed, you were thinking about us. So we can fix our eyes on you, the author and the perfecter of our faith. Thank you, God. 24/7, we can approach you confidently that you will hear us. Thank you, Jesus. The blood of Christ shed for you. Thanks be to God. Let's drink. Partake of the Lord's cup. Let's worship God one more time before we end. Thank you, Lord, for your faithfulness. We honor you, God. In Jesus' name.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace be, the hour of first believe. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior, has ransomed me. And like a flood, His mercy rained, unending love. Amazing.
See my chains?
My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior, His mercy reigns, unending love. Amazing grace, unending love.